One of the things you can do with the wizard is you can convert your performance equations to ACE calculations. And here I have the Visual Basic, and I've selected from the add-ins menu PIPE2ACE. And it's going to show me for my server and given point source all of the PEs that have been created. These are performance equations, by clicking on Convert PEs. And what you'll see when that gets done and the hourglass goes away is all of my performance equations are going to be shown here. Now, I've only got one. I created one for this specific example. And if I go to Report, I can see that there are total of one performance equation with valid syntax and translated successfully. Now, not all performance equations are going to translate successfully, and you will need to tweak some once you get into the code view. But what I can do is come here and I can go to my ACE structure and click on Generate ACE Executables. Now, what that's going to do is generate the code and the ACE structure that I need. These are the executable name and module name that it showed me a few moments ago. And I can edit this and, oops, it says it's already open. It says I can edit this and I can see my sample equation here. And if I wanted to, I could debug it and figure out if there's anything that wasn't correct in it. Or since this one's very simple, I think I'll just go and test it. And I can see that when I test it, if I get a value for the current value, I think I should be okay with this. And I do. I get a value. Current values for my input tags and my output alias gets a value, so I can close that. And I can go in and register this equation with the same scheduling structure as I had in my performance equation. And you'll notice that it even picked up the zero offset and 30-second period from the performance equation itself. So I can do that, register my ACE context, and I can go back into my ACE manager, and you can see that it is here, it is out of service. I can resume calculation and start up my executable, and then that tag, that output tag, will begin to be written by my ACE scheduler and not the performance equation. Now I will have to go in, and I should go into my point builder. You can either use point builder or the performance equation scheduler, or performance equation if you want. And what you should do is you should change the point source of this tag to L, or something that indicates that it is not under the control of the performance equation scheduler. I'm going to do this in the point builder. I'm going to search for my sampled equation. And I'm going to change this point source to an L. And what that will do is that will take it out of the control of the performance equation scheduler. You'll notice if I go into the performance equation scheduler and search, I don't find any tags. And it will put it under the control of the ACE manager. And so I should continue to see this tag update for the foreseeable future.